Okay, this is going to be a quick tutorial on how I do my little bumpy earring pairs. I've gotten out dark ivory, double helix aura, Moretti clear, and I forgot what this is called, opal yellow. So what I'm going to do is start by making the base rondelles. Gather going. Start by making two donuts on one mandrel. I usually do two at the same time because working with silver glass, I find it difficult to get two that look exactly the same, so I find it easier to do two on a mandrel, because then they're both getting like the same exact reduction flame. Anyways. And I actually do use my bead roller. I mean, I have a decent shape. It's not that. It's more just to make sure they're consistent in size. Could eyeball it, but I have the tools. I might as well make use of them. My rod of opal yellow, and I'm going to put six dots on each bead. The best way to do that, to have them pretty even, is to turn down the flame here. Do the first dot. And the second one, I'm moving it so the dot is almost to where I can't see it. Still barely see it. And that's how I divided in the third. And on the other one, I should have it so I can just barely see the dot on the first dot, and I can just barely see the second dot on the top. So that's one divided in the thirds. And to do six, I just put one in between them. I know you need to add a little bit of glass to make these dots more even. You can see one of these dots is kind of shrimpy. Just add a little more glass. Now I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I can either do it the same way, doing a dot, moving it to the horizon, another, and the other, or I can just line it up with the first bead that I did. Either way works. Should be better. Melt those in. Having two beads on a mandrel is I can do a little bit of heat on one and then move back to the other one while the first one cools off, so I don't have it falling off the mandrel from too much heat. It's efficient and I enjoy efficiency. Down a little bit while I'm preheating my clear rod. I just use plain ephedrine clear. Some people use zephyr and stuff like that. I am very cheap, so what I do is I pickle all of my clear rods, and that keeps things pretty clean. I still get scum sometimes. I usually will remove the cut end of the rod before I start working, which I already did. That seems to help. Now I'm going to switch to a reducing flame and just gently run the bead through it. I don't want to heat up the bead too much, that's why I'm just kind of quickly rolling it through the flame until it has a nice metallic finish. Sometimes if I give it a little bit longer of a reducing cycle, I'll get like some subtle pinks to them. Alright, that's good. Now I'm gonna get my clear, and I need to work a little bit quickly because I can't really put these back in the flame until I have the dots encased. Heat up the end, the clear rod, push it down on the metallic, pull it out, flame cut it. Start heating them up. I try try to focus most of the heat on the clear dots as opposed to the base bead. I have one clear dot that I kind of missed and it doesn't match the others, but I'm going to fix that in a second. I'm just melting it in as much as I want. I'm trying to get it as even as I can so I don't have like half melted in and half sticking out. I look at it from the side view so I can see if there's any rogue dots that are sticking out more than I want. Bit on that side, so I'm going to focus a little bit more heat on that. But I do have to keep the rest nice and warm. And it's looking a little better. Have a good amount of heat is I usually put some sort of little accent dots. Sometimes I'll do metallic, sometimes I'll do silvered ivory, sometimes I'll do just plain ivory. I think I'm going to do metallic with these, so let's see if I can find any aura. There's some. This is just a random little piece of aura stringer. Turn down my flame, heat the tip of the stringer, tap it down. I'm doing this on the side of the beads, in between the larger dots. That's one side. I'll switch to the other bead so everything keeps evenly heated. Melt those guys in. Back to the first bead on the other side. You really just kind of get a rhythm going for that. So stringer to the flame, stringer to the bead, cut it, stringer to the bead, stringer to the flame, stringer to the bead, cut it off. I can't talk as fast as I can actually do it. Everything's pretty well melted in. Don't want anything to fall off or get bumped off in the future. Gently rolling them through the flame. I don't want to heat the bead too much. I'm just trying to make sure that it brings the silver to the surface. And that's it. All done.